we used to say every time I
turn it around.
Oh, Lord, keep so blessed. Yeah. I can't get around enough.
Yeah.
Lord, keep so blessed.
I'ma turn it around.
All right. Woo.
Yes.
Bless him.
Yes.
Woo.
Turn it around.
We give God praise.
Everything. Oh my God. Everything.
He had said this morning that she was going to preach.
Yeah.
And I'm going to just sit back and just throw an amen in every now and then. Glory to God. But we thank God. Let's thank God for Pastor.
My God. Excellent job. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes.
Such an encouragement to
yes,
me.
Yes, yes, yes.
Thank you. Like she just said it. She was saying it. And then I talked to Pastor Bill, and I said, you know, we need our own building.
Yes,
we do.
Tell us like it is.
They're calling it to us. Yes.
Deeper life again.
Yes. Woo. Yes.
Because everybody might not be ready for everything.
That's right.
But what lets me know that you're ready is when you sacrifice to be there.
Yes. Yes.
And when you're there, then now you're at the place called there, where you can properly receive some of the things that God is releasing in this day. And in this time, and as I was sitting there, and Pastor was sharing that I was going to speak, one of the things that I wanted to just share with you all is that each and every one of you possesses a destiny code. Say it with me. Say a destiny code.
A destiny code.
And what has happened to us is that religion has separated us from that code that needs to be turned on. And if that destiny code is not turned on, what will happen to us is that we will go around and down the same block.
Yes, yes.
And fall into the same hole every time.
Yes, yes.
But we need a change.
Yes, yes.
And something needs to be turned on in us.
Yes, yes.
Look at the person next to you. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Apostle.
Apostle.
Has the code.
All right.
All right.
Amen.
That will literally, see what happens is this. When you don't want to get into something, you don't try hard enough. But when you know that there's a place you want to be, and when I say a place, I'm not talking about a physical place like this. I'm talking about a spiritual destination. And what happens to us is sometimes we forget why we're here.
Yeah.
Every one of you that are sitting out here, you came here to leave a deposit.
Yes.
Come on, say a deposit.
A deposit.
What happens to us is that we sometimes want to withdraw from something that's not there.
Yes. Yes.
And it's impossible for you to make a withdrawal when there's no money in the bank.
That's right.
And we're trying to pull from someplace that nothing was put there for you.
Wow.
See, but when you understand who you are,
and
you came into the earth to deposit something, to leave something. See, most people come to want to take something. That's how most people mind.
Yes,
humanity
yes.
mind. What would you? What can I get?
Tell it like
what
it is.
What can I have?
Tell it like it is.
What about what can I give?
Yes.
You know what happens to us? We say the scripture and we were prone to the scripture to understand it another way. The Bible said, give and it shall be given unto you, good measures pressed down and running over.
Hallelujah.
But most people in the assembly, they associate that with money.
Yes.
It's a whole lot more than
yes.
that.
But it means so much more than that.
Yes.
The Bible said, give. When you learn how to give of yourself and the gift that God put in you for me, give and it shall be what?
Given.
When you give of me the talent and the gift that's in you, then I begin to release the gift and the talent that's in me.
Yes.
Wow.
That will begin to bless you you bless.
Yes.
Wow.
Listen, we put so much emphasis on money.
Don't get me wrong.
Because really, it's a form of exchange.
Yes, it is.
Yes. Your gifting is a form of exchange.
Yes, it is.
When you allow your gift to bless me, then my gift will return and bless you.
Yes.
Can't beat it.
It says, give, and it shall be given unto you. Ha!
Press down. Shaken together.
Good measures.
Neighbor,
I'm ready to give you a good measure.
I'm ready to give you a good measure.
And I'm going to press it down.
And
you will shake it together. Because what will happen is, you giving me and me giving you, then now we can make something happen.
Yes.
Most people in the church, they're not making anything happen.
Come on.
It's a ritual. You come to church because it's Sunday.
Right.
And you will roll up to come to church on Sunday.
Yes.
But what did you get when you came?
My God.
Tell it.
How did you lead out? Did you lead out with something? Or did you lead out with nothing?
My God.
Well, wait a minute. Most people that are in the church, and when I say church, I'm going to use it like y'all use it, the pseudo church, because I know what the church are. We are the church.
That's right.
But what happens is we leave out worse than what we came in.
Yes. Been there and done that,
You done seen something?
Yes.
You done heard something?
Come on.
And now they gave you the load to carry.
Tell the truth.
We allow people to fill us up with trash.
And
now you have nowhere to dump it.
Wow.
I got it.
That's true.
So now you become a deposit.
Yes, sir.
A deposit of stuff that's not good for you. What do you put in the garbage can?
Trash.
Garbage.
Something that nobody wants to what?
Eat. Keep nothing.
Hallelujah.
And what we do, we hold on to it.
Yeah.
What happens to garbage when it's there in the garbage can too long?
Stink.
It starts doing what?
Stink.
It starts doing what?
Stink.
That's how some people are.
Yes. Lord have mercy.
Yes,
God.
You smell it.
Yes.
Good girl.
Because there's nothing good coming out of it.
Wow.
All you can do is talk about what bad people are doing.
Come on. Wow.
Not knowing the force that you are. You came here to make a deposit.
Yes.
You came here to leave something. When I translate, I want to translate empty.
Come on.
I want to be able to deposit everything that I came here to deposit.
Yes.
Into God's people. You need a deposit.
Yes.
A good deposit.
Hallelujah.
Something that you can draw on.
Yes.
Glory to God. When we talk about you loving one another.
Come on.
Yes.
When you begin to feel bad, all you got to know is somebody loves.
Somebody
loves.
Yes.
And you can say what you want to, but everybody needs love.
Yes. That's right.
Everybody.
Yes.
You can say what you want to. Everybody needs love.
Yes.
We have a Yorkie, Coco. Coco, no. I love Coco. Don't get me wrong. I love Coco. But I don't like Coco to jump on me. I don't like that.
Hallelujah.
And I'll come in the house, and now mind you, she knows.
Yes.
Pastor come in the house, the girls are coming out, she'll jump all over there. But once I come in the house,
I should just look at you.
See, listen, If Coco didn't know that I love her, she would never come around you.
That's right.
That's right.
She just know I don't like her to joke.
That's right.
Jump over, Coco.
Amen.
When you know people don't care about you, you don't go around there not knowing and not really understanding the love. See, love is contagious.
Yes, it is.
It's a disease.
Yes.
A good disease.
That will catch you. Mm-hmm. And sometimes when love catch holds to you, it has an ability to touch other people that are not good.
Yes, it does.
Yes.
It's contagious.
We have been so prone to not loving ourselves we can't tell when other people love.
Wow.
We think they're trying to do something to us. Instead of putting something in you.
Yes.
In order for us to be,
tell me like it is.
The spirits that came to earth to inhabit a body, we have to know how to love.
Yes.
Because whether you know it or not, you came from love.
Yes, right.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
You were created in love.
You were created in love.
You were sent here in love.
Yes.
You chose to come here. And because you chose it, you had a gift with you. You had something in you.
Tell it like it is.
That you need to give away.
Yes.
Giving is actually what?
Receiving.
People running around talking about, nobody loved me. Well, do you love you?
Does somebody love you?
If you love you, guess what? Other people will love you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Because of the
truth. We're trying to attract something that we're not giving.
Come on now. All right.
You want people to love you.
But you don't want that.
But you don't love you.
Oh, my gracious.
So sad.
And when you don't love you, other folks won't love you. See, you need to learn the mechanism of how things work.
Yes.
There is a working organism that has the ability to work.
Yes.
Yeah.
See, the universe knows what it's here for.
Yes.
Uh-oh. We're the ones that don't know what we're here.
You like that, sir?
Right.
We're stumbling around for years.
Wow.
Oh God, why am I here? Well, let me tell you something.
Tell
me
like it is.
If you were sincere about that question, you will never ask it again.
That's right.
Because you will know.
Yes.
The Bible says, ask and what?
It shall be given.
Good God.
When the last time you showed up, ask God, why am I here? I had a period in my life. Let God know, I had a period in my life where I literally forgot why I came here.
My God.
I caught amnesia
Come on.
On the way.
Yes.
Holy God.
Teach
your pop. On my way coming out. Y'all think y'all can get there?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, we got it, yes.
On my way, climbing out the womb, what comes out first?
It's supposed to be
water. Water.
No. What part of you come out the womb first?
Head. Oh, okay.
Hallelujah.
On my way, out the womb. My head came out. Now, when my head came out, I got to know everybody.
Wow.
Came out of darkness.
Yeah.
And stepped into light.
Wow.
What happens when the light comes on?
You see.
You have the ability to see. Sometimes you don't always know what you see.
That's true.
But you can see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then you come out babbling.
Yes.
Do you know why you have to babble?
Mm-hmm.
Can I share? You heard what Pastor said?
Yes.
She told me to give it to you, and I did.
Yes, yes she did.
I'm going to give it to you.
Thank you.
Do you know why you come out babbling?
Resisting.
No, because you can't tell me.
No, you can't do it. That's right.
Because society ain't ready to know that.
Right.
So what happens to us is that through our babbling, because how many of you know that babies talk?
That's why babies talk. Yeah, they talk.
And if they can't articulate what they want to say, then they'll act it out.
Yeah.
How many of y'all had babies?
Mm-hmm.
Parents, right? How many of you knew when they were wet? They let you know they
were wet.
How many of you knew when they were hungry? They let you know when they're hungry.
Yes.
Now, when you're hungry, what do you say?
I'm hungry.
They can't say that.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So they articulate it. So now you understand what it is that they want. Mm-hmm. And then what happens to them, they get around us and they learn the talk that you talk.
That's how they do. That's true.
Get domesticated.
Yeah.
Negative stuff.
They do. Uh-oh. They do. They do.
You know, talking about the husband. You know, Johnny ain't gonna never be no good. Now, mind now, the baby hear that.
Yeah, right. That's true.
This ain't gonna never work for me. The baby hears that. That's
yeah.
Right. Understanding what you're investing in that child.
Yes.
And when they grow up and they're not what you think they ought to be, that's what you put in for them.
Good girl.
That's right.
Wow, that's true.
Tell it back to you.
You put that in them.
Yeah.
When you see these athletes and musicians and things like that, they didn't start out when they were 12 or 13, the majority of them.
No. Mm-hmm. No.
They started out when they were 2.
Yeah. Yep.
That's right.
Tiger Woods' father put a golf club in his hand when he couldn't hold it.
Sure. Yeah.
He couldn't help but be a professional.
Mm-hmm.
Good girl. Mm-hmm.
But what is it that we're putting in our children?
Come on.
That's right.
To cause them to be great
within
themselves.
Within themselves.
Not with nobody else, but in themselves. Because let me tell you something. The greatest treasure you can ever find
is
the God that's on the inside of
you. Good God.
Yes.
And that God that's on the inside of you will envelop you.
Yeah.
Yes.
And the gifts that's on the inside will begin to manifest in you.
Yes, it will.
Mm-hmm.
And instead of you being a liability in the earth,
you
become an asset.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord.
9 times out of 10, most of you that are sitting here today, you know, why you're here.
That's right.
You know why you're here. Mm-hmm. Some people say, well, I was born to be a preacher. Well, that might be.
Not true.
I'm going to hold off on that. Well, I was born to do certain. Well,
maybe.
What we do most of the time, we copy what we see others do. You're born an original, but you leave here
a copycat.
Yeah.
Ask God sincerely, why am I here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes.
And if you ask them, am I now? You've got to be sensitive to the answer.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah.
Because when the answer comes, your spirit will bear witness to it and say, that's it. I know it was something.
Mm-hmm.
See, my gifting, I can talk.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
I can talk to just about anyone.
Yes, you can.
Doesn't matter where they come from.
No.
Doesn't matter what they're doing.
No.
I can talk to you and not condemn you.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know why I don't condemn people and judge people? Because I know people And I know it's not them. A lot of things people say, I know that's not you. That's not you. So why would I take it serious? Because understand this. When you do that, if I give you the wrong reaction, you keep doing it. But if I don't react the way you think I ought to, you know, most people, when they cuss you out, they want you to cuss back at them. Make them feel better that they ain't do nothing. You cuss your face off, and then they'll stand back up. Now, what you got to say? You know what they need to say? Baby, I love you.
Yes.
You will break them down.
All the way.
But as soon as you take your stand, and you start with them F-bombs,
they won.
They got you now. Because they got you. But I dare you to stand back and say, look at you. Look at your pretty self. Acting like that. You ought to be ashamed. They start to whip it then. Because what happens is they start feeling bad about us.
Yes, yes.
Now why did I say that? How many of y'all have been in the place where people didn't fight you back and you said, why did I say that? Come on, tell it to me. Hey, you the only one?
I guess. I would be real about it.
You didn't really mean what you said. How many of you said stuff that you really didn't mean? Don't be pushing his head up.
Yes.
I know I have. And then you say to yourself, I'm not saying that.
Yeah.